Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a common question about mapping the latest element of an association. But before we talk about it in detail, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get a new Hibernate tip video every week. So here's the question. I want to map the latest element of a too-many association as an entity attribute. How can I do that with Hibernate? You can either map the element to an entity attribute or execute a JPQL query. The mapping is a little bit tricky and creates an overhead which you should avoid in most situations. If you don't use that specific element in most of your use cases, you should prefer a JPQL query to get the latest associated element from the database. Let's take a look at both options. I will use the following simple model, which you probably know from a typical online store. It consists of a book entity, a review entity, and a one-to-many association between them. The mappings of both entities are relatively simple. The review entity maps the primary key column ID, the comment as a simple string, the date and time when the review was published as a local datetime, and it also defines a many-to-one association to the book entity. The creation timestamp annotation, which I use with the posted at attribute, is Hibernate specific. It tells Hibernate to set the value of this attribute to the current timestamp when it persists a new review entity. So you don't need to set the creation timestamp yourself. The mapping of the book entity is even simpler. It maps the ID attribute as the primary key, the title as a simple string, and the other end of the association to the review entity. Okay, so let's take a look at a JPQL query which returns the latest review of a given book. This query is relatively simple and should be the preferred approach if only a few of your use cases use that review. You can either use a function to select the entity with the highest posted at timestamp, or you simply order the associated reviews by their posted at date and limit the result list to the first element. I chose the latter approach in this example. The mapping to an attribute is more complicated and will affect how Hibernate loads all book entities. You should only use it if all of your use cases require the latest review. Otherwise, you should select it with a JPQL query. You probably expected to model it as a one-to-one association with additional join criteria. That's what I intended to do, but unfortunately there is a bug in Hibernate 5.2 which prevents you from using a join formula annotation with a one-to-one association. You need to model it as a many-to-one association instead. The join formula annotation is Hibernate specific and enables you to provide a native SQL snippet as the join criteria of an association. Hibernate includes this snippet into the generated query and compares its return value with the primary key of the associated entity. So in this example, my SQL snippet needs to return the ID of a review. As you can see, I am using the same idea as in the previous example. I select the ID of all review records, which book ID is equal to the ID of the selected book, order the records by their posted at value, and limit the result set to the first record. When I now select a book entity from the database, Hibernate includes the SQL snippet defined in the join formula annotation and maps the latest associated review entity to the latest review attribute. Here you can see the generated SQL statement. Unfortunately, Hibernate includes the SQL snippet in the select and the from clause of the query. Depending on the SQL snippet and the optimization performed by your database, this might slow down your application significantly. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!